Hi, it's a Monday, and I just came back into my cluttered kitchen, and I realized it smells good in here. Somebody asked me, in fact, more than one person has asked me about the cocotte I keep in here. It's a Dutch oven, and they're really useful. And I can get you one. They sell for about 20 to 30 euros in most cases here in Europe. It's a French staple cooking item. Now, the reason that you would want to get a genuine French one is because the good ones have grooves or indentations in the lids. And there are a lot of reasons for why that is desirable and why Dutch ovens, cocottes in other countries don't have them, and that's no good. And maybe I'll put some information in the low bar about that. Now, these are some onions which are sautéeing in a little bit of butter here in the cocotte. And the only herb or spice I've added is a little bit of a strange mixture I got in Turkey in 2010 called Fleisch. I don't really know what it is. It's almost gone. I've got some cauliflower baking in here. I steamed the cauliflower. Now, what I wanted to show you is I'm making Swiss steak. Now, these are a couple of very small beef steaks, and they're tough and low fat. And this is a really good way to tenderize them and to cook them. And they take a little while to prepare. It's not difficult. You could definitely use a meat mallet for this, but I learned to do this here in Europe just with the side of a plate. And this is wheat flour, but I'm gluten intolerant. I should be using buckwheat flour. I'm not. I don't know why. But for this, you can definitely substitute buckwheat flour. And these get rather thin and rather large. And you keep turning them. You don't put any salt in the flour because you never want to salt red meat before it's cooked. Almost never, because that'll toughen it. You also don't really want to turn anything more than once. You know, pancakes, eggs, meat, fish, you know. The more you turn it, the more it'll toughen. Just, you know, turn it once. And that's it. If even once. Some things you don't turn at all. And you keep going like this until most of the flour, and there was a lot of this when I started, gets absorbed into the meat. You go across the grain and against the grain, and more flour goes into it. I started this quite a while ago. I'm doing this down in the sink because it's a little bit neater. And I'm a messy cook. So I'm going to put this into the cocotte with the onions. See, it doesn't quite fit, but it doesn't matter. I could use a big old frying pan with a lid also. And I'm going to add a little bit of water into there. And I'm not going to use stock or anything. Goodbye, flour. Goodbye, Yellow Brick Road. I'm not going to use stock or anything special or wine or anything in the way of liquid. I don't really find that it's necessary. I can just use a little bit of ordinary tap water. And this should cook for quite a while, you know, 30 to 60 minutes. You have to keep an eye on it. And because you're adding the water in there, see, I'm not even turning it, I'm not even browning it. Because you're adding the water in there, it's going to make a beautiful sauce, and it's going to keep cooking, and because I've been pounding it for a long time, it's going to be pretty tender. Naturally tenderized by my beating it. I'm going to put the lid on. I guess I could add a a little bit of thyme or something, but I'm not going to bother. A little bit of red curry would probably be great, but again, I'm not going to bother. So this is going to cook like this on a low flame for 30 to 60 minutes. I'll keep an eye on it. And then when you serve it, you put it on a board or a platter, and you can slice it or else just put it directly onto a plate, and you spoon some of the sauce with some of the onions over, and this will be served with some baked cauliflower, which I'm kind of doing in a braised method in the oven, and I'm not going to bother you with that. And I've got a little bit of leftover rice from yesterday. I'm going to try to rehydrate that. And since this is France, we'll probably have a selection of fresh fruit and cheeses and yogurt for dessert. Okay, see you later. Bye.